Swift, we often write closures to transform collections, to sort values, extract properties, or combine results. But some of the most concise and expressive ways to do this are less widely known. In this video, I'll cover three techniques that simplify common collection operations using function references, keypath, and in-place accumulation. These techniques can help you write cleaner, clearer code, and in some cases, improve memory efficiency as well. To sort an array in Swift, we can use the sorted by method. It returns a new array where the elements are arranged based on the ordering defined by the closure we provide. The closure must take two elements of the array as parameters and return a Boolean value, indicating whether the first element should be ordered before the second. The code we have works, but it's verbose and difficult to read at a glance. We can achieve the same result in a much more concise and easy way. Let's see how. In Swift, basic comparison operators such as less than and greater than are functions that take two parameters and return a Boolean value. This function signature matches the closure type expected by the sorted by method, two parameters of the element type and a Boolean return value. Since Swift lets us pass functions as arguments where closures are expected, as long as their signatures match, we can simplify our code by passing the less than operator directly to sorted by. The updated code is much more concise and its intent is immediately clear. Now, let's look at simplifying collection mapping. Suppose we have an array of person objects and we want to extract just their names. The typical way to do this is by passing a closure to map that returns the name property. In this example, the closure simply accesses a property and returns it without applying any additional logic. In such cases, we can write it more concisely by passing the keypath directly. Starting with Swift 5.2, keypath can be used more dynamically, including the ability to be automatically converted into functions. When passed to map, Swift treats the keypath as a function that extracts the name from each person in the array. This approach isn't just shorter, it also more clearly conveys our intent. When we use keypath in this way, it's obvious that we are not transforming the values, we are just accessing a property. The last technique we'll explore focuses on accumulating collection elements into a single value using the reduce method. For example, we might want to build a dictionary that stores the frequency of each name in a list. One way to do this is by using the version of reduce that takes an initial value and a closure that returns a new result at each step. This works, but it creates a new dictionary on every iteration, which can be expensive for large collections. Instead, it's often better to use the reduce intervariant. This version also takes an initial value, but the closure receives a mutable reference to the accumulating result and the next element from the collection. Unlike the standard reduce, it modifies the result in place, which avoids allocating and copying intermediate values. Because the result is mutated directly, reduce inter can be significantly more memory efficient, particularly when working with large or complex data structures. If you want to learn more concise and practical Swift techniques to simplify and optimize your code, check out my book, Swift Gems. It includes over 100 tips to take your Swift code to the next level. And this week, my friends from Those Who Swift newsletter are running a special promotion for their readers, offering 30% off my book with a coupon code. You can find a link to their newsletter in the video description. Thank you for watching. I hope you found it useful. See you next time.